Hi, this is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to tell you how to sell your art on Redbubble. So you might be wondering, what is Redbubble? Well, it's this site right here, and you can upload your own artwork that you've made in Illustrator or Photoshop and have it put on t-shirts and a lot of other products like clocks, bedspreads, you name it. They probably got it. And then people can buy those things. And it's really a passive way of making money because all you have to do is put your art out there and Redbubble does all the work after that. So they make the t-shirts and they send them to the people and you don't have to think about it any more than that. So it's really cool. So first I'm going to show you how to sign up with Redbubble. So I'll get an incognito window since I'm already signed up on that other account. And then you just go to sell your art. Go to redbubble.com, then sell your art. And then you just fill out this section, get started, it's free. Make up a username, do an email address, password, just the general account details that you do anytime you sign up for a new website. I'm not gonna go into it more than that because it's really similar to everything else. You usually have to verify your email address and all of those things. So we'll switch over to Illustrator now so I can show you about how I set up my files. Okay, so we'll create a new document and I'm gonna make it 15 inches by 22 inches. And that's a pretty good t-shirt standard size for your file. If you're wanting to make clothing for men, a good round number is anywhere from 12 to 14 inches wide by however high. For women, I usually like to go 10 to 12 inches, but really it's up to you. It's your decision. I already have some artwork made. This one is obviously probably a women's graphic. So I'm going to go ahead and shrink up my canvas. I'm going to hit Shift O. And then pull the canvas up to just where my artwork ends. So I'm going to be putting this graphic on several dark colors like red, orange, blue. And so really all I need is the white. I don't want the red. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that. And it's kind of hard to see now. So move it over onto the gray for now. Okay, so you can see I have made some changes to this and covered up some pieces of the white that I didn't like. And I need to get all of that red out of there and just have white only. So the way I'm going to do this, I have a bunch of things going on here. I've got a live type path. I've got some strokes. I've got some fills. I'm hitting Command Y to see all of the artwork. I've got a clipping mask. So I'm going to expand everything first, and to do that, I'm going to first create outlines on my type. That's Shift-Command-O. And then I'm going to expand everything else all the way out, which is Command-E. Expand. So it looks like I have no more strokes. Now I'm going to select everything that has a white fill, except for the city. And I'm going to go ahead and combine that with the Pathfinder Unite tool. And if I look over here, I only have a fill, no stroke, and that's what I want. Doesn't really matter, but I just find it easier to work with in this case. So I'm going to hit Command 8 and make a compound path of that. I've been having a little bit of trouble with this heart. It doesn't want to use Pathfinder Unite to divide it out correctly. So I'm going to take this outer heart out, Command X, paste in front, and then re-clipping mask this, Command 7. And then we'll use this crop one right here. And that will give us the effect that I want. So if we Command Y, we've gotten rid of all that extra information out there. There are pieces of this that I still don't want. So I'm going to grab these two things and bring them to the front. And I think now we're in a place where the divide will work the way it should. Selecting everything, and then we'll just divide everything out. And now I can hit the Y for the Y tool, which is the wand, and select all the white, unite it, and make it into a compound path. And now I can just go back and delete everything else, and then unhide. Option Command 3. Okay, so now I only have the Kansas City stuff. And that is exactly what I want. So I'm going to put this right here. White on white, it's going to disappear. I'll create a new artboard and I'm going to copy this and then paste in front. Whoops. And I'm going to change this one to a dark gray. So these are the two artworks that I'm going to submit today. We have a white one, which won't show up at all until it's on a dark background. And then we have a dark gray one, which shows up fine. So now, to export these, the best way to do it that I found is to go to File, Export, Export As. You'll want to use your artboards and export to PNG. And I'll say Export. And then I want to do High, 300 PPI, and the background color is transparent. And Type Optimized Anti-Aliasing. So say OK. So let's go back to Redbubble. So I'm logged in. I can just go here to add new work. And here, I'll just click this image once. And I'll choose the first one, which is the white one. And it takes a little bit of time to upload. And now it'll give me all the products that I can put this on. Everything right now is white, so I need to change that. I'm going to click this one, and we'll change the color to dark blue. And now our image shows up. I'm going to increase that a little bit. There we go. And that's all you do. You just go through and you change each one. Some of them only have certain colors available. And you can move it around and then grab the next one. Some of them I don't really like for my art, so I won't put it on that art. Some of them you can choose any background color. Okay, let's try the dress. Maybe we can make it, maybe a red dress. We'll make the size a little smaller, put it up here. Okay, and then if you don't like some of the clothing, you can just disable it like this. And it'll gray it out. Stickers, I'm going to disable that because that's what it'll look like. It'll be white on white and it will not turn out. Pillow, just make sure every time that you do this that all of your stuff shows up the way it should. So if you have white, it's not going to work. All right, I don't think anyone's going to want this on a duvet, but they might want a laptop sleeve. Let's change that to maybe a cool looking blue. Okay, maybe also a coffee mug. And we'll shrink that down also, but I think I want this to be maybe more of a navy one. Ooh, I do like that. Okay, I don't think we need any pants. No on the skirt, no. Maybe a tablet case. And the thing that really takes a long time is this part of it, is just going through and making sure everything looks right, assigning it to all these different products. It is kind of time consuming, I'll say that. Put that there, maybe a little bit smaller. There we go. Sure, who doesn't want a Kansas City spiral notebook? And I will say when these objects are printed, they are kind of a washed out looking color. My husband bought one of mine and it came kind of faded looking. So keep that in mind when you're designing. It might not look as bright as your image. Okay, I'm going to disable that. Nobody wants a clock. Okay, and now the title. It is true that 4 to 8 words is best. So I'm gonna put Kansas City Heart Design. I love Kansas City Heart Design. In here, you wanna just mention what this image is. Casey Love. We can put Casey Mo, Casey Kansas, Missouri. I have some tags from my other designs that I'm gonna just paste in here. But you want them to be really relevant to your image so that people are able to find it. Then you can just come on down here. I usually put digital art and design and illustration. When you have default view, you can just choose what you want to show it on. So I'm going to put on a women's premium t-shirt. Anybody can view it. And is this mature content? No. And you have to check this box that says you have the right to sell it and you made it. and then just save your work. And it does take some time. I usually make two versions of everything, kind of a light garment version and a dark garment version. So that way I can sell two different things and I kind of cover all the bases. So I really recommend you do that too. When you're done, they actually show your t-shirt on a model. So you can promote this on Pinterest, Facebook, or whatever you want to do. And that way you can get more sales. It's really awesome. When you sell your item, so let's say somebody comes along and they pay $38 for this. That means you're going to get about $6 or $7 from the sale of this specific t-shirt. Some of the others are cheaper. I think you can sell them for about $24 and you get about $4 as your cut for that. So yeah, promote the heck out of it. That's what I say. All right. So if you guys like this video, please click on the like button. That really helps me. And if you want to see more videos like this, just subscribe and I'll see you next week. Thanks, guys.